Hello, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamoworld.com, and welcome to this After Effects tutorial about using stabilized precomps with our extension MochaImport Plus and the Mocha plugin that is bundled with After Effects. As an example, we want to manipulate the building here, and with the help of MochaImport Plus, this will be surprisingly simple and a whole lot of fun. We start with a composition that contains our clip and launch MochaImport Plus from the window menu. With our clip selected, we now choose the Mocha version we want to work with and click on Track. Since we've chosen a plugin version of Mocha, this creates a Mocha effect on our layer. For standalone versions of Mocha, MochaImport Plus will send the clip to Mocha instead. In the effects controls, we click on the Mocha button to open the Mocha user interface. We are working with the Essentials user interface, which is designed for beginners. If you are an experienced Mocha user or are familiar with the user interface of older Mocha versions, you can also switch to the Classic user interface, which contains many advanced controls. Now we draw a mask roughly around the area that we want to manipulate, and make sure that in the tracking options, perspective is also enabled. With perspective enabled, tracking is slower, but often more accurate. Now we click on the track backwards since we are currently at the last frame, and then wait until the track is finished. Then we close Mocha and save the changes. To load the tracking data into MochaImport Plus, we first click on Create Track Data on the Mocha effect and then select the Mocha layer from which the track data should be loaded. Then we click on the Load button to load the data from the plugin effect into MochaImport Plus. Now we create the stabilized precomp. Stabilized precomps are always created on a duplicate of the background layer, so we duplicate it and give the duplicate a meaningful name like Wall. Then with the wall layer selected, we choose Stabilize Precomp and click Apply. In this dialog, we can choose the corner pin effect that should be used to create the stabilized precomp. We use the default CC power pin here. Also make sure that the Live Expressions option is enabled because it will allow us to adjust the region that is included in the stabilized precomp. Finally, make sure the resolution of the precomp is set to 100%. Lower resolutions only make sense if you create stabilized precomps for very small portions of your image and want them to render a bit faster. If we hide the background layer for a second, you can see that the stabilized precomp looks exactly like the background, but only contains the region that we tracked. It also moves with the track. In the event controls, you can see there is a corner pin effect on the layer. It moves with the track, but since we enabled the Live Expressions option, it only has a single keyframe. We can change this keyframe now so that it contains exactly the region we want to manipulate. We set the region so that the edges of the corner pin are parallel to the wall. Then, on the left side, we make it a bit larger since we want to extend the wall in that area. Also, this region moves accurately with our track now. Now let's double-click the stabilized precomp layer to open the precomp. Inside the precomp, we can see the region that we have just chosen and it is perfectly stabilized. Therefore, it is easy to make any kind of manipulations. Let's duplicate our background, for example, give it the name Window, and add a mask around the window here. Now we can move it over here, and maybe scale it down a bit. In just a few seconds, our building has an additional window. If we go back to our main composition, you can see that the window is visible there too, and moves accurately to the track. Now we go back to the stabilized precomp and add some more complex manipulations. We duplicate the background again and name the duplicate Wall Extension. This time we draw a mask around the entire area here and move it to the left. We add a second mask here to give this part a nice rounded shape and set its mask mode to Subtract. Here the edge is a little bit visible, so we add some feather to our mask to soften the edge a bit. This is what it looks like now in our stabilized precomp, and here is the result in our main composition. The great thing about this workflow is that you can really do any kind of manipulation inside the precomp. You can use the clone stamp tool, bring in other images, and do any kind of compositing work. Inside the stabilized precomp, you don't need to worry about the movement anymore, and everything you do is automatically also visible in the main comp. If you compare what we created so far to the final result, you can see that in the final version, there is also a bit of the bottom visible right here. This is a bit tricky to create, but helps a lot to sell the effect. What I actually did was simply add a solid with some noise. A few mask keyframes were all I needed to animate its shape over time. In order to get the perspective right, I looked for parallel edges in the scene and simply followed their direction. That's the end of this tutorial. I hope it gave you some ideas of what you can do with stabilized precomps in Mocha Import Plus. Again, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamoworld.com, and we'll see you next time.